In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to add these date picker controls to your VBA user form. Now these things are so cool. They give you this nice little calendar that you can use to select dates when entering data into your user form. So let's check out how we can do this.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Engineering Toolbox channel, where I give you the tools you need to solve real-world engineering problems.
So if we want to turn these text boxes into date pickers, we can do that. And what we have to do is actually add a object or control library to the available controls here. So if we go to additional controls, we can actually see that there are more controls available to us, but not the specific date picker control that we're looking for. So in order to add that, we have to go and search online for this msconfct2 OCX file. And that, when we download that and register it, that'll give us the ability to add those date pickers. So the one I use is right here. So if we go to that page and then we hit download, you can see I've already downloaded it. Let me just type in AAMY to let it know I'm not a robot. And then we download that. We open it, and then here is our file. And we need to take that and cut it and go to our C drive and then go to Windows and let's see here, the sys64 folder, and then paste that. And since mine is already in there, let's just replace it. Actually, it's gonna say I can't because I'm using it, I think. Yeah, so we'll skip that part. So you'll paste it into this folder, and then if we have to register it now, so if we type in cmd to open the command prompt, we'll run this as administrator, and we will type in reg svr32, and then we will go back to our folder where we pasted that and then find it again. So MSCOM, we're looking for MSCOM CT2, core properties, security to find the file location, copy that and paste it here. Problem is, you might have the same problem, is it adds that little question mark in front of the file path, so we have to delete that. And then when we hit enter, it'll say that it registered it. And then we can close this, close down all of our other windows here. And then now that control will be registered with Excel. So then we can go to additional controls and it should show up right here, this Microsoft date and time picker control. So we'll just check this so it shows on our toolbox here, and then click the date picker and we'll drop one in there, size it, and then we'll just copy this, put another one below there, and then we will change this to match up with our old text box controls. So we're going to type in txt start date, and then this one will be txt due date. And now if we run this, we'll see our date picker controls. It defaults to today's date, and when we click that arrow, it drops down with a nice calendar for us, just like you see in a lot of other applications. So date picker test. And we'll add that, and then we'll see that it populates our date values just like it did before.
All right, I hope you all enjoyed that one. To get more videos as they are released, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, make sure to like and share. And if you didn't like it, well, then leave me a comment and let me know how I can improve. Last but not least, this channel is for you, so if you have any suggestions for topics you want me to cover, make sure to let me know. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.